shall we come to the very word of Jesus Christ, excellently recorded in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 17. 17 of Matthew. I'll begin reading from 14. And when they were come to the multitudes, there came to him a certain man, kneeling down to him, saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is lunatic and so vexed, for often times he falleth into the fire, and of into the water. And they brought him to thy disciples, and they could not kill him. Then Jesus answered and says, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him hither to me. And Jesus rebuked the devil, and he departed out of him. And the child was healed from that very hour. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart and said, Why could not we cast him out? And Jesus said unto them, Because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say unto this mountain, Remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. The very word that we would like to take for this evening is, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Shall we lift to God in prayer? Thy hand be upon us today. Your anointing be upon everyone today. To have faith in you, to believe you without any single tiny of doubt. So that as your word says, spoken out by our Lord Jesus Christ, if you have faith, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Let this very word be real to us today. Change our life, our world of life, our world of the family, the world of the church, the physical world, the United Kingdom, the whole wide world, will be changed by faith in you. That is your power. I pray, God, that you will bless, not simply blessing, but empower everyone today. Anoint them with your Holy Spirit from above on high. And God, Almighty Father, I myself need increase in faith. Have mercy upon us. Help us to understand what faith and how to believe in your words, which will change everything from today onward. And the world will know that Jesus is doing mighty things through us. Bless your word, Jesus. This is the very word that you have spoken where you were on earth physically. And now in your Holy Spirit, come and speak again. Open the eyes, the minds, and the spiritual eyes of your children. Help them to understand. Well, come in. We
we come to your presence, your presence, your presence. Your presence is your real to us. Your power is your real to us right now. Come everyone in the name of Jesus. Grant them faith to live and to do mighty miracles. Many miracles. And to see the mighty hands of God by faith alone. Grant my people a faith that will remove the mountain ahead of them. Grant them Jesus. Grant them Jesus. Authorize them. And make them. Empower them. With a giant face, mighty from as small as a grain of mustard seed, yet from today, by your power, by the fresh anointing of the Holy Spirit, that little face, small face, will increase into a giant face. Then it will the mountains. And then upside down the world. I pray for all these things. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 Brethren, today I just simply want to say, I'm not going to give you so much illustration. I would invite you everyone to meditate on the words of Jesus, who says, nothing shall be impossible unto you if you have faith. I'm not going to deliver a systematic and very well organized message, but I will just speak what the Lord puts in my heart for you and for me. Meditate to the words of Jesus. We have prayers. The disciples were not able to test our beings because of lack of faith. Jesus rebuked his disciples. All ye little faith. If you have a faith even as tiny as a grain of mustard seed, say to this mountain, remove, it shall remove. Removing a mountain is much difficult than casting a demon from a child. Not being able to cast a demon means lack of faith. Lack of faith means lack of power. Today Jesus wants all to have a faith. It might begin with as small as a grain of mustard, yet the Lord will increase to a giant faith to fight the big giants for Jesus' sake. Amen. I will just simply say a few things, brethren. It is all faith throughout the Bible that moves everything, that removes every unwanted thing, that removes even a single sin or a single evil spirit, moved out by the power of the Lord through faith. Pastor Marius says, the word says, sin is believing. But we say, believing is sin. Amen. The word says, sin is believing, which means you believe only when you see. Because there's a proof, there's a sight, seeing, proved. Yet the word of God for the Christians, believing is seeing. If you will see. If you don't, you will never see. You pray, 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 never happens. Because I don't know how many percentage of doubt in your prayer. God does not want even a single person of doubt in your prayer. Just a complete set 100% of faith is required to remove the mountain in your life, to remove the issues which you don't want in your family, to remove your poverty, to remove any evil word within your children, and to remove the devil's power in the United Kingdom. Look at a few things. It's Noah who simply believed what God said to him. Believing is believing in what God says. In other words, faith is simply believe what the Lord says for you. No question, no logical thinking, no critical thinking is required for moving things mightily. A simple faith that moves the mountain. Noah, as we said, so simple, so sincere. The rest of the people in his time, the whole world, did not believe what God says, but he believed.
Amen.
His family followed his faith. They were all reckoned as righteous family. That's the reason why Noah's family was able to save the human generation. Only believe in God. Just a simple faith is the tool that changes the total human race in the time of Noah. Things are very unbelievable from secular or the world's perspective. Say, for example, when people build ships and boats, they near by the sea, near the ocean, at the port. But God told Noah to build on the top of the mountain. The peak of the mountain is completely different. Man built in the seashore. God taught to build at the top of the mountain. What is up, what is up? Completely different man's perspective and God's instruction. Which one are you going to believe? The one may say different things for you and for family. The one may criticize the church. Your Christian life might be criticized by the world. Are you going to shake yourself or firm in your faith and go ahead? Firm in your faith means believing what the Word of God says that makes you successful. Noah. Look at Abraham. He did not know where to go, but God told him, I will tell you step by step. Many people want to know plans ahead of time for his or her whole life. Well, if God's willing, he might. Yet the biblical principle is God takes his people step by step, amen.
Amen.
Step by step. Every single step is in the hands of God. And there's never a mistake of failure. Those who believe in the word of God. Simple enough, but mighty power. Simple faith, mighty power. That's all. Think about Moses, Abraham, wisely. Now, Isaac was already born. And again, God is demanding the same person to whom he promised to make Abraham a great nation to kill for sacrifice, to kill Isaac for offering. Look at you from the world's perspective. How can God fulfill the promise if Abraham kills his son Isaac? Yes, whether fulfilled or not, whether good or bad, whether right or wrong, Abraham did not care. Whatever the Lord says is always sensitive to listen to the voice of God. If God says, kill him, he is ready to kill him. Believe in this, the word says, after I have killed my son, God will raise him up again. Up to that much faith, he was firm in his faith in God. Now sometimes, you may feel the promise of God and the reality, the actual life, the circumstance might conflict one another, crash one another. But be faithful to the word of God. Faithful and just simply believe what the word of God says. He will create the best for you. He will take care of his word, make fulfilled in your life. That is his responsibility. Your responsibility is to believe in him. He is able. Just simply believe. He is able. Without doubt, if you just believe, he is able. That's enough. That's a giant faith already. That's a giant faith already. Just believe that he is able. He is able. He is able to heal. Yes, he is able to make you great. He is able to speak. He is able to make you rich. I forgot the name of the author who writes a book, I Can Make You Rich. We got a book. We got a book. We have a good number of books collected. Books on beauty, books on food, books on spiritual food, books on wealth and richness. We have a book called I Can Make You Rich. It's good, isn't it? The title itself is good. I can make you rich. I really don't know whether that book or that words makes you and me rich. But I believe that book makes the author rich.
Yes.
That's all I know. But my faith in God will make me rich. He will not fail. He is the author of my big book, which I believe for death and life. I pray I will never doubt every single doubt in the Bible. I'm sure the thing that I'm not sure is whether. Is it Napoleon? Napoleon Hill said that, I forgot. That book makes me rich or not. As I said, I believe the book makes him rich because the title is so attractive. Many people bought one of the best-selling books. Millions. I believe the book has made him millions. But I'm not going to that. I'm going to the big book of God. question without any critical thinking. A simple faith in me. God is Christ. And I believe every single word, every single letter, every single dot in the book, the Word of God, the Book of God, is benefiting. So mighty power of God. I am so glad that I have this book. There is salvation for me for every need. That's why I just quote and give credit to Pastor Chris in Nigeria, who says, everything you ever need for your life is wrapped up in the Word of God, and go for the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
This Word of God, by believing them, will make you healed, will make you powerful, will make you rich, will make you successful, will make you ever prosperity. I know this will make you prosper. Amen.
Amen.
Go to the Word of God for your life, for every single bit. Every answer is in the Book of God. This is about Abraham. A simple faith, without murmuring, without doubting. If God says, kill Isaac your son, he did. He was about to kill, only a few seconds did. God spoke to him. Why he was ready to kill? He believed that God will never fail his promise. Even if I kill, even if I kill, he will raise him again up to dead man's face. Without faith, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Faith makes God pleased. When God is well pleased, he is happy, he is excited to do something for you. Even we humans, if you are not happy, you can do something. Make God happy or pleased by believing in him. When he is happy, he will do greater things than ever before. Go ahead, Moses. Look at a few things in the Bible. Moses, as we all know, not ready to go to Pharaoh's house. Yet God said, he obeyed by faith in God. There was competition between Egyptian magicians and Moses. The rest of Egyptian musicians come from the world. They have some power. We should not disregard them. But the power comes from above is more powerful than the power comes from the earth. Amen. That's why by faith Moses was able to deliver our nation from a very strong holds of Egyptians and let them into the promised land. All is by faith alone. Go quickly, David. When he fought Goliath, he was very little. When he put on every armor that was available at his disposal, nothing was fit to him. It was simply to try. No, not fitting for me. But the one that makes him is his faith in God. The God who was with me when I was fighting with the lion, the bears, he will be with me now also. That faith the great, the giant Goliath, Goliath he forces by faith. Think about it. He should, from the front, if Goliath was died by the shoot of David, he should have fallen bad words. But the Bible says Goliath fell down front. That means David played a little game. The real fight was done by the unseen angels from the back. The angels beating them while David was fighting in front of him. So the angels are think about it a little bit logical. If Goliath was died by the shooting of David, then he would have just fallen backward. But the Bible says, fall forward down. That means shooting of David is just formality's sake. To fulfill God's assignment. Just to fulfill His own work, His assignment. The real fought, the real fight was done by the unseen angels from the back. I don't know how many angels came down there for, but I know enough angels. They were just speaking from the back. Weapons they use, but I am sure they were stronger than Goliath. That is the method that you are going to exercise now. Just believe and obey the assignment. A simple faith. Then the angel of the Lord will fight for you. You don't need to slap them. You don't need to beat them. Just obey what the Lord tells you to do. Be obedient and children of God. He will fight the battle. That's why the word of God says, the battle belongs to God. Amen. The battle belongs to God. For you, thus, you will have to stand in faith. Just stay in faith. That's all. The work is done by the Lord. The fight will be fought by the Lord. His angels are already there. Millions of angels. That's what the psalmist says. The angel of the Lord, encamp around the saints. Amen. The angels of the Lord are encamping around you. What are you afraid of now? What is impossible with you? If you have a simple faith, Jesus says, Matthew 17, verse 20, be, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Look at David and his friends. We all know by faith when they were charged and driven, they said, well, whether you put us in the lion's den or in a fiercely fire, seven times hot of fire, God will take care of us. Even if He let us die, we will still be very happy. Amen.
Amen.
Let us give a big hand to God. Heroes of faith in the Bible. Marvelous. Come to the disciples. You all know you have had thousands of times. That they all were simple and ordinary people. Fishermen. Not even school leavers. If they were school leavers, I don't think they would do fish. Look around in the United Kingdom. School leavers do not do fishing for their life. Only very, very uneducated people, very ordinary people, unlearned people, before they believe in Jesus. And they were made, they were changed into extraordinary people. Amen. That's why the book of Acts says people were amazed. Why these people were unschooled? Yet, the way how they preach the gospel is something amazing. Soon after they realized they were with Jesus. Amen. If you are with Jesus in spirit, you will be like the disciples who finally turned the world upside down. Look, Acts 17:6. Here are the people who turned the world upside down. Think about yourself, my brethren. Your present life by faith can be changed into extraordinary men and women. What difficulty do you have today? Change in faith. You can train a new world for tomorrow. By the time I meet Jesus, my life is never the same. And it will never be the same again. Now in faith, Jesus is in front of you. The Holy Spirit is introducing about faith today to your hearing. Accept it. Accept it. And then your life will never be the same again. Your life will never be the same again. Your family will be greatly changed. The church will be changed. The world will be changed. We commit for Jesus. For 21st century, national or nationwide, a revival in the United Kingdom. We pray and commit for Europe, revival. We pray and commit for world evangelism. Would you join this commitment today? We all want to be rich. Says, yes, the thief cometh to steal, to destroy, and to kill. But I come to you so that my sheep would have life more abundant, full of life. For Jesus came to offer abundant life for every one of us. BMC and Breaking from Slum. You will never be the same again. Today is the church, BMC, will never be the same again. It will move in power, with mighty power in Christ. It will set the United Kingdom for the kingdom of God. It will set the United Kingdom for Jesus' sake. Would you join his commitment? It will take